Dear students, now we discuss crystalline allotropes of carbon. We have already discussed that allotropes of carbon belong to two categories, crystalline and non-crystalline. Out of which all the three crystalline forms of allotropic forms of carbon are very important from some or other point of view. So let's look at these three crystalline allotropes of carbon are diamond, graphite and fullerene. As we discussed, fullerene may be a new term to you because fullerene was not known to even mankind since very long. It's a recent discovery, though they were part of interstellar space and geological formation of Earth. It means they were existing since long, but we came to know about them recently only. So, in case of fullerene, we'll discuss diamond and graphite later. Let's discuss fullerene. Fullerene is a third crystalline form of carbon. Two crystalline forms of carbon, diamond and graphite, we have already known since ages. But the third crystalline form of carbon, fullerene, we came to know about it recently, but it is existed in interstellar dust and geological formation of Earth. In this fullerene, carbon atoms are held together in a cage-like structure, and in which number of carbon atoms may vary between 30 to 900 atoms. It means there are different size of fullerenes available and they are named differently, out of which one which was discovered earlier and is of the most known and useful fullerene is known as C60. And it was named after Richard Buckminster, the scientist. That's why it is said to be Richard Buckminster fullerene or just Buckminster fullerene. It is also known as buckyball, and it is because when it forms, take the shape, that it looks like a football or ball from outside. So, and it is very useful. It is used as insulator, as well as some compounds of fullerene are used as superconductor. Things which are used very recently only. So, uses of fullerene as insulator and as superconductor. Let's come to diamond and graphite, the other two crystalline forms of carbon. Diamond is known as hardest naturally occurring substance. Though there are so many allotropes of carbon, but out of all them, diamond is very hard. This is because that in diamond, all the four valencies of carbon, which are distributed in tetrahedral manner, each of the carbon atoms, four valencies are also connected to carbon only. And in turn, this carbon's four valency also to carbon atoms. Then this, and this. It means all the carbon atoms, they combine with another four carbon atoms. And in this way, it becomes a very rigid tetrahedral structure. Due to very rigid and compact tetrahedral structure of carbon atoms, in which, as I said, each carbon atom is joined to another four, and all the four of that to another four, and then another four. In this, it becomes very compact, and therefore it is so hard. So let's discuss. Let's compare other two crystalline form of carbon, that is diamond and graphite. The comparison as well as these properties of diamond and graphite both are important to be understood and remembered. First, the appearance, which is the most common one. If you are asked to write differences, better don't write this difference but other differences. So it is colorless, transparent, whereas graphite is grayish black and opaque. It's not transparent. Then diamond is the hardest naturally occurring substance, whereas graphite is soft and greasy or slippery. Due to this reason, in the heavy machines part, we use this graphite for lubrication or greasing purpose, because it does not melt at very high temperature as well. So it stays there as lubricant. Then, and you also know that due to being soft, it is used in pencil lead. Then density of diamond is higher than density of graphite. डायमंड इज 3.5 ग्राम्स पर क्यूबिक सेंटीमीटर और सेंटीमीटर क्यूब, वेयर एज डेंसिटी ऑफ ग्रेफाइट इज 2.39 ग्राम पर सेंटीमीटर क्यूब. देन ग्रेफाइट इज अ गुड कंडक्टर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी. As exception to non-metals, graphite is a good conductor of electricity because out of 4 electrons of the carbon which form bond, the 4th electron stays free and other 3 combined with other carbon atoms. As a result, it is a good conductor of electricity and is used for making electrodes for electrolysis as well. There is one more form of carbon, or one more allotropic form of carbon as we can say, which is a good conductor of electricity, but that is a non-crystalline allotropic form of carbon known as gas carbon. So if you are asked a question that name a substance, non-metal, which is a good conductor of electricity, then you can give two names. You write carbon in the form of graphite and carbon in the form of gas carbon. Simply carbon won't be a correct answer, then it will be a wrong answer, because not carbon in all form is a good conductor of electricity. Then graphite and diamond, both as they are allotropes of carbon, it means forms of carbon, therefore just like normal coal or coke, they also burn to form the same substance, because chemically all the allotropes are same, just their physical state is different due to different way the atoms keep bonded between each other. So diamond burns at 980 Celsius. But when it burns, it will form, say, that is carbonate. And graphite burns at 780 Celsius. So these are the difference between diamond and graphite. That's all for this chapter.